Hi, my name's Emma, and I'm a huge book nerd.
You're my library, always open for business, but you never show it. You're just sitting with them, but I know the score, and you're killing it.
So today, I am filming a spooky book recommendations video, and I have decorated appropriately. We got a happy Halloween, we have a pillow, we have my But First Hocus Pocus shirt. We are all prepared. So I'm going to recommend several different types of spooky books. I also wanted to recommend an age range of books. So we're actually going to start with a middle grade book. It's called The Hunt for the Seventh by Christine Morton-Shaw. So basically The Hunt for the Seventh is about a little boy named Jim who goes to live, I think it's with like his aunt and uncle at this manor house basically. And he is haunted by six dead children while he's there. And they keep telling him he needs to find the seventh. It has been a while since I've read this book, but I know that when I read it, I loved it. I read it several times. It's just a really good, spooky middle grade ghost story. Perfect for Halloween. The next book I'm going to recommend is the only YA on this list, and that is The Wicked Deep by Shea Ernshaw. And this was the Booktubeathon group book, I think. This is about a tiny town in Oregon that has a dark history. There is a legend of three sisters who were drowned as witches a long, long time ago. And now basically every year the witches come back to like haunt the town. And this was just like, it's so atmospheric. It's a little creepy, but it's not like scary, but just the atmosphere of it is so fun and so Halloween-y that I was just like, yes. I just really loved like the atmosphere of the town. There's like so much fun stuff happening in the town in the book. The way that Shea Ernshaw writes the atmosphere is just great. I'm kind of structuring this in like order of scariness, so I'm like building up to the scariest. So the next thing I'm going to show you is a series, and this is the Coromon Strike series by Robert Galbraith, aka J.K. Rowling, and this last one, Lethal White, just came out this month, and I've already read it, and it was incredible. If you are a big fan of, like, detective stories, you have to read this series. And I personally, like, I love thrillers, but sometimes I steer away from detective-led novels because they can be generic. Like, you know, it's like a subgenre that's within mystery thrillers that's really kind of overdone and can be done really badly, but this is done so well. So even if you're not the kind of person who leans towards detective-led mystery thrillers, I still think that this is a fantastic series. I would keep holding them up, but they're kind of heavy. Start with the first book in the series, The Cuckoo's Calling over here, and then you've got The Silkworm, and then Career of Evil, and then Lethal White. The Cuckoo's Calling is a little slower, but once you get into The Silkworm, it takes off and it's like wonderful. Next, I have a couple classics to recommend you, starting with Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte. You might not think of this as like an October spooky read because it's a classic often like lumped together with like Jane Austen, but this definitely has a spooky nature to it for sure. But if you don't know the story of Jane Eyre is an orphan who becomes a governess for the Rochester household, and she starts to fall in love with her employer, Mr. Rochester, and then there's some spoopy happenings happening. It's one of my favorite classics, if not my favorite classic. I'm a big Jane Eyre fan. Next, I have another classic to recommend you that I read recently, and it is We Have Always Lived in the Castle by Shirley Jackson. So this is about a girl named Mary Cat who lives with her sister Constance in a house outside of town, and everyone in the town hates them, at least according to Mary Cat. And you kind of find out why as you read, and so that's all I'm gonna give you. This was first published in 1949, and Shirley Jackson is an incredible spooky author who just writes the most atmospheric things. This is atmospheric in a way that's a little bit different from The Wicked Deep. The Wicked Deep is a little bit more of a fun fall, like fall festival-y almost atmosphere, where this, I would describe it as cozy, but also deeply unsettling. Like there's something, it's very cozy, but then there's just something that's really off. And you can't quite put your finger on what it is for like most of it. And this is definitely not frightening. If you don't like super scary books, then like this is still a good one for you. Next we have another fun but kind of scary book, and that is Meddling Kids by Edgar Cantero. And this book is basically a reimagining of the Scooby-Doo gang as they come back together years in the future. It's not literally picking up where Scooby-Doo's gang left off. They do change some things and the characters are a little bit different, but it's still a really fun read. It's definitely much scarier than like the Scooby-Doo series. The Scooby-Doo series is all about like masked people who are like pretending to be monsters. There are real monsters in this. So it's the adult version, basically. This did get like pretty creepy, but I really enjoyed it, and it's definitely playing to nostalgia for sure, which I really enjoyed. So if you are a Scooby-Doo fan who has now grown into adulthood, you might really enjoy this. Next, I am going to recommend Stephen King, of course, because you can't get through a spooky reading recommendations video without Stephen King. So I'm gonna recommend two books, and I'm doing that for a reason, because one of them is perfect for October, but it's not my favorite of his books, and the other one is my favorite of his books. So we're gonna start with the one that is perfect for October, and that is Pet Cemetery by Stephen King. This was one of the few Stephen Kings that I didn't personally love, but I know a lot of people adore this, so I'm still comfortable recommending it because it's not a bad book. It's just my least favorite of the ones of his I've read so far, but I'm an unpopular opinion on that, and there's nothing like specifically wrong with this that I wouldn't recommend it, and it is totally perfect for October because it's about a pet cemetery, essentially, and like raising the dead. I think that's a fair summary. That's what I knew going into it, and I enjoyed it. There's a zombie cat in this, which is fun. And we're up on the scary meter now. This is pretty scary. And then we have my favorite Stephen King, which is The Shining. If you haven't read The Shining, you gotta read The Shining. It's so good. It is nothing like the movie. I hate the movie because I read the book first. Anywho, the book is incredible. So if you don't know the story of The Shining, it's basically this guy, Jack, becomes a caretaker at this hotel that's up like in a mountain area, so it gets snowed in during the winter, so he takes his family to go live with him there during the winter while he's taking care of this hotel, and then they get snowed in and chaos ensues and the place is arguably haunted, but also it's a metaphor for alcoholism and it's great. And the last spooky scary book that I want to recommend for October is Bird Box by Josh Malerman. This is possibly one of the scariest books I've ever read. It is deeply frightening because it's kind of dystopian, because they're living in a world where there is something outside, and if you see it, you go insane and end up dead, essentially. No one knows what it is because no one has seen it and survived. So it follows a mother and her 2 4-year-old twin children, and she is stuck in this house. They've like blocked off all the windows and everything. The children have never seen outside ever. And the mother decides that she has to get the kids out of this house and try to find help somewhere. So basically, they get in like a canoe and they paddle down a river blindfolded. It is the most terrifying book because when they get outside, you get no visual description. You get all auditory description and like the thoughts of the characters, and it's so deeply unsettling in the best way. It is terrifying. It is a genius idea for a book. And they're making it into a movie, and I don't know how that's gonna work because like so much of it is about that you can't see, and that's what makes it terrifying. If you've heard of the movie The Quiet Place, it's like that, but as a book. With a movie, it makes sense to do it with no sound, and a book to do it with no sight. It's so good. It's so good. Those are all of the spooky books that I would like to recommend to all of you. I hope that you find a recommendation in this video that will carry you through to Halloween. And thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, comment down below, and I will see you in the next video. Have a wonderfully spooky October. Bye! Now I was headed to the bus stop, Maddie. You were reading in your